So I can't really pick a top three because I probably would have a hard time picking a top 30 with you, my friend. Happy SANiversary. I can't believe it's been this many. I can't, they say time flies when you're having fun, but we've been having a lot of fun over the years. I have to say, some of my favorite moments have been some of the practical jokes that used to occur fairly frequently around the office. One of which is when Shale came to drop off all the Hill stuff at your house and set the alarm off. And so then we punked you and said that she had been arrested. And I tried my best to find that audio clipping and I can't find it. But anyway, it was you offering her a steak dinner. To make it better that she had actually been put in jail for breaking into your home. So that's up there. My other favorite one is the very good. When you were doing, I don't even remember what client it was, but you were doing these interviews and they had some Indian people with some strong accents. And you started saying in the interviews, in like talking on the phone, talking to us, it was very good, very good, very good.
Okay, good. Very helpful. Let's talk. Okay, very good. How about very good, Michael?
That has got to be the top. Gosh, there's just so many. But I've enjoyed this ride with you. I have to say, my top would be when you facilitated Brad's Hills. That changed his life and it changed our life. And we've been through lots of ups and downs together, my friend. And I cannot imagine this ride with anybody else. I love your zest for life. I love the fun that you bring, the fun that we have, and I look forward to many, many, many more years together. Congratulations. Cheers, my friend.
Hey Ted, so I'm gonna have Marley help me out with these. So for the top three memories I have with you, they're gonna start off with you facilitating my Hills One back in November of 2018. It was definitely an eventful experience, and I am truly grateful that you were able to facilitate it. I am still in touch with everyone that went, and we're all such close friends, and we all have you to thank for that. It was definitely an amazing experience. The second one is going to be your passion for sports. So whenever you came into the office, it was either football, golf, tennis, anything sports related was on your mind. You were able to blurt it out and it was so funny. And I was always able to connect with you with that. And I loved that. It was awesome. And the third one, and probably my most favorite, is every Christmas party, you somehow managed to get out your dancing shoes and it is amazing. Whenever you and Vero dance and cut up a rug, it's so funny and I love every second of it. And I cannot wait to hopefully, when this all passes, we can get some more in. But those are my top three, and I am truly grateful that you are in my life, and I truly appreciate you. Thanks, Ted.
Happy 25 years with Stop at Nothing, Ted. What an incredible milestone that is, especially today. Not many people stay at the same company that long. I've only been with Stop at Nothing for about 5.5 years, and I've got some really great memories of you with you. One of them was when I first started with the company. We were doing an open enrollment peak, and you were facilitating that program with Ellen. And I had the opportunity to attend that session with you. And I just remember, I could not believe how incredibly gifted you were with your facilitation skills, how you were connecting with people that you had never met, and how comfortable you made them feel in sharing information with you and the group. That just set the tone for me that I knew I was in the right place, working for an amazing company with amazing leaders. Another memory I love of you is that I've always enjoyed talking with you about your family and raising your children and how I've learned so much from you and how you've done things with your kids. And I've loved the conversations that we've had about talking about Bryce and things I've gone through with him and also with Brenna. And so I'm very grateful for all of that time and conversation with you. But last but not least, Ted, I don't know that I would have ever known about this incredible skit from Saturday Night Live, and it was about, I need more cowbells!
Ted, happy 25 years. This past year and a half, being able to work alongside you has been the best year and a half in my work career I've ever had. And I wanted to start off by congratulating you on 25 years and sharing a few of my favorite memories with you. My first would have to be when we first officially met outside of interviews. So I meet you up at our local Mellow Mushroom in our neighborhood, and we are watching the NCAA final men's basketball tournament. It's your team, UVA, versus, I don't even remember what team. I'm probably gonna hear about this later. So we're having a blast, sharing cocktails, sharing wine, and the only thing I remember thinking is, man, I hope his team wins, because then he'll associate me with a really good feeling of victory, of winning, and that will carry us on through the start of this new partnership that we have. Silly as can be, right? So of course, the next memory I have is none other than the infamous Charlotte trip that took place a few months later, where I got to meet your entire family. We got to experience the Jags game outside of the Jags Stadium, which was a first for me. It was weird cheering in a section for your team no one else is cheering for. And that mixed with a few other components, it was quite the trip, and it was a lot of fun, and just being able to experience that with you was just such a joy and a memory that I'll never forget. My last and final memory with you, this one was kind of hard to pick because there's just so many little special moments in between the time that we've got to share together. It would have to be when I semi-crashed your date night with Nancy and we all walked over to Biscotti's and had salads, had some wine. I got to know you just on a deeper level. I got to know Nancy on a deeper level. I just felt so filled up with gratitude for that special time that we got to share together. And that is all the time I have, because I am taking up this screen time. I want to say again, cheers to 25 years. I have enjoyed every minute of my time with you. And if I haven't said it to you before, I wish I met you 25 years ago and we could have started this journey a lot sooner. So cheers, and looking forward to seeing you.
Happy SANiversary, Ted. Congratulations. It's your 25th. What a milestone and what an adventure it's been. I feel so honored to have been a part of many years of that. And as so many others have said, there are many fun and fond memories that come to mind when I think of you. It's really hard to narrow down to the top few, but I'm going to do my best. One of the memories that comes to mind is something that just you and I have shared over the years, which is our conversations around Spartanburg, South Carolina, and Converse College. Our time spent there separately, of course, but my alma mater and the Clevelands, your family history. Go Converse! Also, the opportunity to have supported you as a CSM directly and still being able to partner with you on projects today. It's a real gift to be able to learn from you and watch you do your magic with our clients. You are a natural when it comes to that, and to tune into people's needs. It's been really fun, and I can only imagine the number of lives that you have changed and directly and indirectly impacted over the years. The many years of Christmas parties and events, namely Miss Fantabulous, I think that might single-handedly be one of my most favorite memories, and without a doubt, one of the top five memories of times that I laughed so hard I did not think I was going to survive. Thank you for that. The entertainment you bring to every event just by being there, and the joy and the fun when the party really begins, when you are the first one on the dance floor, and if I recall correctly, probably the last one on the dance floor, too. Ted, you have such a genuine willingness to smile and have fun, even in tough times. You are seriously a wonderful
consultant and facilitator, but you never take yourself too seriously. And that is a lesson and a message that I take from you. Thank you for your devout commitment and loyalty to Stop at Nothing and to each one of us. We are truly blessed by you and all that you have contributed, and I thank you. I think I can speak on many people's behalf to say that you have left a mark on everyone that you've crossed paths with. I know you have for me, for sure. Congratulations and happy 25 years. Thank you, my friend.
Three memories of Ted. This is hard because you think of Ted and so many things come to mind. First, funny Ted. Funky sense of humor, lay back. If you give him 2 seconds, he's gonna keep going and it's just gonna get better and better. There is that side of Ted. Then there is a really sweet side of Ted that can be very compassionate, can be really easy to talk to, very easy to connect, and just somebody that you know cares. And then there is Dancing Ted. And that's definitely one of my best memories of Ted. It doesn't matter when I'm gonna be 70 and I'm gonna remember Stop at Nothing, and I'm always gonna go back and think of Ted as the guy that danced like crazy at every Christmas party. Going back to my first Christmas party at Stop at Nothing, where Ted and Nancy put up a show, and I remember just sitting back and watching and thinking, oh my God, I had no idea Americans could dance. So Ted, thank you for that. Thank you for thank you for educating me on the dance moves of Americans. You definitely can do salsa way better than I can. And then that takes me to last year, you dancing in my living room. That's just going to be priceless. I'm always going to remember that. And I really, really loved it because it was Christmas and it just made it feel festive, fun, relaxed, and it kind of opened it up for everybody to get loose and dance, which I love to do. Another memory of Ted, it's going to be very recent, and I wonder if other people have this memory because it's just, I think it's going to be one of those things that we're always going to look back and remember that Ted did this. So Ted was in charge of putting up an activity for the company's first virtual happy hour. And in that, Ted told us to bring memes. And I remember I spent like 2 hours looking up memes. It was like the best 2 hours ever. It was COVID related and what we had been going through. And then everybody brings the most inappropriate memes ever. Sorry, John comes to mind.
John comes to mind. But we all brought very inappropriate means. I brought one that was like a cocaine bag, and but it was hand sanitizer, because that's how we were at the beginning of COVID. Like, who has hand sanitizer? Like, if we're dealing drugs. And then we're all bringing up all those memes, and then Ted comes out with a beautiful poem. And this beautiful story of his walks with Nancy Powell around their house, and how, I'm never gonna forget, he just, it's so beautiful and it's just so perfect that he actually says that in one of those walks, he's walking and he sees a brick that has the Powell's names, Laura Jane, Teddy, Scotty, Nancy, and Ted. And it was just like a moment of gratitude and of remembering their history there. And it was just so pretty. And in any other instance, it would have been like one of those moments where we're all crying. But we were all like, what the heck? Anyways, I don't think I'm gonna forget that, especially because he was in charge of the exercise. And it led to that really sweet side of Ted. And that's gonna be my last, my third memory of Ted. And it's really cute. So Ted has this thing that when we're doing something, either if it is a small group we are gathering, you know, for happy hour, just chatting, and if we're sending some sort of gratitude message to the ops team, or if he's just talking to you, he talks to you, he listens. And then the sweetest thing happens. At the end, he always says, I love you. I remember that for the ops team this year, we made a video for the Administrative Professionals Day. And I was going through all the videos, and at the end of Ted's video, he looked at the camera and he said, I love you. And the way he said it, I get goosebumps, because the way he said it, it was so truthful. And I don't think that it's every day that we get a boss, a partner, a leader in our organization that really cares about people this way and expresses it in the way he does. We went out for happy hour not too long ago. Kevin had to come over for a Land South sales pitch in Jacksonville. It was the first time any of the consultants got in a plane. So we decided, the four of us, John, Ted, Kevin, and I, were gonna meet for a happy hour. And we had the best time. We were drinking wine, having appetizers. We're there just for like an hour and a half or two. And at the end, we had just such a good time. And at the end, he didn't hug us because it's COVID time. But maybe we were doing air hugs. But he was so happy that we got together. And again, he just blurts out like, I love you guys. And it just stayed with me, because it made me feel like this is not only work, right? This is people that we care about and that we really, really love. And just to hear it, that's one of my favorite things of Ted, and I think it really changes the dynamic. It changes my relationship with him, how I see him, how I trust him on him, and how I love him too. Ted, I love you, and I know all of us love you, and you know, there is really nobody like you. So those are my three memories. I think I can keep going and going, because Ted just gives us so much material. And even not being here, the short shorts come to mind. I was not part of that experience, but I'm gonna take that with me now and forever. but no, really, Ted, thank you for being an amazing partner, an amazing leader, and a great friend. We love you so much. 25 years at Stop and Nothing. You're obviously a big part of who we are and what we do and what we've become. And for that, we thank you. Happy anniversary. We love you.
Hi, Ted.
Hi.
Wow, 25 years. Congratulations. And thank you for everything that you do for San and for all the impact to, you know, so many lives. I have a clear memory from what it feels like it was yesterday when I attended one of the many Pepsi Peaks that you facilitated last year. And it was amazing to see the impact. It was great to see you facilitating and all the anecdotes. I really learned so many tools that I am still using in my personal and professional life. And then thank you so much for that. I wish you the best. And all any plans that you have in the future, and I'm sure it's going to be amazing. Thank you for everything again, and felicidades.
Hello, everyone, and more importantly, hello, Ted. The pattern's here, clearly.
Hi, Ted.
And to see that, totally unrehearsed. I was we wanted to share a few stories, Ted, kind of over the years, known you for 15 years and made an indelible mark on me and Tina over time. And as Tina and I did a little bit of prep thinking about the things that really stuck out. And one of the things actually was, you know, some of the parties we attend. And the dancing that goes on between you and Nancy. And I say that because it's incredibly entertaining to watch. And Tina, you were talking about what?
That lovely look you have on your face, Ted, when you're happy, you're dancing, you're grooving to the, moving to the groove. And it's very infectious.
Yeah. So I agree with all that. I might not have said it as quite as nicely because you do have some incredible facial expressions that you pull. But more than anything is just, I know you and Nancy have got an incredible, you know, kind of relationship, and you really see the joy that both of you have. I do also remember your time here for one of our Christmas parties where Jessica Bianchi, where you got yeah. more than you could possibly have picked off, and she wore you into the ground.
Yeah.
The second thing I wanted to share was your creativity. You know, I think it's an absolute bonus to the company. And you've contributed over the years in, you know, very, very creative ways. But if anything, that's been to the forefront during, you know, the recent, you know, times where you've kind of really led on the creativity side. And, you know, it's something that I value. I know the company values. As you know, sometimes your P can bump into my J when you want to change everything at the last possible moment. I want you to know I really do appreciate that, although sometimes I don't in the moment. And then the third thing is just your love for the Jags. Yeah, you know, it's really, really, really poor judgment. You know, I can't help but just be in awe of your passion for an absolutely awful NFL team. And the other thing I said, I mentioned this earlier on, you're just a tremendous amount of fun to work with, and also, you know, to hang out with. And it's been fun to get to know you and Nancy and your wonderful children over the years. So I hope you have a fantastic night tonight, and hope you get the sense from the rest of the organisation that, you know, they feel like Tina and I feel about you and your contributions. So thank you ever so much, and have a good evening.
Bye, Ted.
Ted, congratulations. 25 years of Stop Nothing is truly an accomplishment. And I, for one, have been thrilled to have you as a partner over this time. And it's going to be hard to break down appropriately 25 years of experience into a short video clip, but we'll give it our best shot. But before we start, it's a nice summer afternoon, and any hoodles. Ted, it's 5 o'clock someplace. It's only about one or two here in Park City, but we're close enough. When Ted first joined the company, one of the ways in which we found out that Ted was with Stop and Nothing was we started to get calls from people saying, you know, hey, you know, Kevin, you're with Stop and Nothing. Do you work for Ted Powell? Which is amazing because Ted had literally only been with us for about a day when the whole city of Jacksonville thought that he actually owned the company and had purchased it. So he kind of came in with a bit of a flair. The first road trip I did with Ted, I learned pretty quickly that Ted was not capable of doing anything while he was talking. Like literally nothing at all. Ted can talk and he can do things. He can't do things and talk. Because we did this road trip down to Orlando and Ted would be very engaged in conversation. And as Ted became more engaged in the conversation, he would look at me. And as he looked at me, he would take his foot off the accelerator. And as the conversation got more riveting, we just kept going slower and slower. There was a point in the drive to Orlando where we were going 37 miles an hour on the interstate and people were honking and flipping us off. And Ted's response to that was that he had never been in a moving vehicle accident that was his fault. So anyway, that's delicious. Anyway, so the moral of the story is it's probably good to not talk to Ted and do anything that could cause harm or death. Rosé is delicious for this kind of event. So one of the, you know, speaking of road trips with Ted, the joke was always, when you're with Ted, if you know Ted, you don't need 6 degrees of separation. Really 3 degrees will handle it. And maybe even 2. And Ted and I were in Manhattan on a trip one time, and we were talking about how it had been his old stopping grounds, and I made the comment, you know, lightheartedly. I said, well, Ted, it's amazing. We've been here in Manhattan for an hour or two, and we haven't bumped into anyone that you know. And we were having that comment, and as we crossed Fifth Avenue in Manhattan, Ted ran into one of his old buddies from work in the middle of the street. And naturally, as Ted would be wont to do, stopped to talk to him and almost got us all killed. So the moral of the story is don't cross streets with Ted ever. That can be very, very dangerous. Out of all the mules, I believe the Moscow mule may be my favorite. Probably. I may stand corrected. Might be the Kentucky mule. Speaking of mules, did I ever tell you about what kind of an ass Ted was on this other trip? And then she just slapped him. And that was the end of it. And we didn't know what happened after that. But I gotta tell you. Anyway. Cheetos might be the official food of the Ted Powell video roast. Speaking of Cheetos, reminds me that you never want to tell Ted a story that could be shared for anything. Ted's been known to take a story and to not let the facts get in the way of what actually happened so that he can, you know, continue to tell the story and it gets better each time. And, you know, there's many stories about my marriage that have shown up in Pete classes that don't actually resemble my particular marriage, but the stories are excellent. So, that has nothing to do with Cheetos, so. Anyway. put this shit here? Anyway. I don't remember. Oh, yeah. Did I tell you about the time that Ted told the story about... Oh, fuck, I told you. And he's a pen stealer. Every goddamn pen ends up in Ted's office. Every pen for 25 fucking years. Ted, buy your own fucking pens. They're not that expensive. Covfefe! And one more story about a vacation that Ted and Nancy and Andrew and I took together on a plane. No, wait a minute. That wasn't me and Andrew. That was someone else. Any hoodles, Ted, here's to you. 25 years of being a stop-at-nothing mule, meaning an ass.